The calendar, traced back to Guinea, emerged as a general term for stick fighting. A more comprehensive meaning of calendar covers both the stick fighting dance ritual, and the songs and other performances that accompany the ritual. In Trinidad, this art was enhanced with the sticks used on plantations for protection against snakes. There is also an East Indian form of stick fighting referred to in Trinidad as Gatka. Kalinda songs are rebellious. These songs constituted chanting in a warlike manner in the African call and response pattern, in which the singers boasted of their feats or those of the main stick fighters. There are five phases of stick fighting. The challenge, the lavwe or call and response chants in either patois or English, the kare or display of physical prowess, in which stick fighters perform rapid dance-like steps in a crouched position while circling around each other. Or attack, in which opponents attempt bus head, also called bois or pui. The pa, during which the defeated is taken for bloodletting to a blood hole inside the gael. This is the most scenic route to Mayaro, a beautiful avenue of coconut palms with the Atlantic Ocean washing the coastline. Most people in Trinidad and Tobago associate Mayaro with miles of sandy beaches and coconut galore. Associate Mayaro with fishing, but few know of Mayaro as one of the most famous stick fighting villages in Trinidad and Tobago.
My name is Ayubre from
here. Yeah, right. Now tell me something about what do you know about stick playing in Mayaro way back when?
Stick fighting from since I was a little fella, 17 years I've been sick.
In Mayaro,
yeah? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Since in Boss Street, that is.
So tell me some of the highlights of your experiences.
Well, at that time, stick had no kind of interest. I got my finger break, I got my head burst, no money. So I leave stick for a little while. But I could still play again.
What made stick playing so famous in this neighborhood, you think?
Well, I wonder if I could answer that question.
You know, the other
people... I feel well, then. was my feelings from since young coming up and watching stick. That was my feelings at prison.
And you feel that was the feeling of most young people in your days?
Plenty people in Miero, plenty people. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, I was thinking what made Miero so important as a stick playing village as against places like Irene and Paliseco and so on, that they don't play stick usually there.
Moroga Miero was famous here. Because we used to go Moroga come down by we and we fight and stick, who get cut, anybody could get cut.
Between the two villages, which you think was better? Which village? Miaro?
Well, I can't see. We used to get cut, them used to get cut.
All right. What do you like about stick play? What do you like most of stick play?
The feelings. Huh? The feelings.
Of the drama, what?
Yeah, the drama. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
When you hear that drum, what does it do to you?
Like you get sick.
You get?
Sick.
When you hear the beat of drum?
Yeah, this is why I don't come on
real again. Oh, I see what you mean. You get like a kind of homesick, you want to do it again.
Yeah.
So
I don't be around.
And when you used to this thing, what the drum used to be?
African.
You see, plain competition stick is something from plain open stick.
What is the difference?
The difference in plain open stick is that you can hit 3 on 40 if you want.
Okay.
You can have no laws there.
Alright.
But once you play competition stick, they make their own law. Right. And then you have to play by that law. Now, when we went to San Francisco to play the North South, they had their own stick. The community had their own stick, the committee.
They had their own rules.
They had their own rules. They had chaos about the way the stick. It must not have no brass, it must not have no tape, it must not have no nut, it mustn't bend. He was there, he'll tell you. Then they have first stay there, mm-hmm. and you get caught, they take care of you.
Yeah.
You know, they had doctors and everything there.
Mm-hmm.
Now, just tell you that it's stick a man. Mm-hmm. You invite your band, great band. That was the law of the game.
Okay.
So anytime. You treat Bama to Bam Bam. It's qualified.
You can't
get a double stick.
Oh.
No, well, in my opinion, once the stick committee have the rules,
yeah.
and you go against it, you're not the better man.
Oh, I see what you mean.
You understand?
So that's the name of the game.
Yeah, because if you look at John Ben Johnson, what they call him,
yeah.
he won 100 yards and win.
But he had a bad idea.
He had drugs. So he lost.
Yeah.
You understand?
He was the fastest man.
He was the fastest man. He lost.
That's the rule of the game.
That's the rule of the game. You understand?
Yeah. So tell me, what made you get so interested in stick playing? Yeah?
Well, what made me get so interested? When I was like 14 years old, thing,
mm-hmm.
we used to be playing. Like we go to work in the estate, we played Coco Chippo, mm-hmm. we played Cookie Flex, we played with Big Stop, we played with Shoot, and then we cut and we play stick in the bush.
All right. Now, some people may not know what's Coco Chippo.
Well,
explain that a little.
Coco Chippo.
No, that young.
Coco Chippo is the young brand that grows up on the side of
yeah.
it. That you get a little stick from.
Yeah.
All right. As a stick.
Oh, okay. I know.
They call that the Chippo or the Coco.
All right.
We start playing with that.
Yeah.
We even take Langbep and play with it.
All right.
So I grew up with stick. From the age of 14, I started that.
Mm-hmm.
And I never had no other love of carnival more than stick.
Mm-hmm.
I played about 60 different guys through Trinidad, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I played commission stick in the Savannah for Senegal.
Mm-hmm.
I and this fellow, brother called Boogie. His name is Wellington Gordon.
Boogie.
That was my sparring partner.
What do you consider your best game in the history of your stick playing, if I had to ask you that now? What do you think must stand out as one of your best in your memory?
I had some very good plays.
Mm-hmm.
But I won't call the North South the best because that is my second stick. I caught the King there, the VT King there, and then I won't call it the very best. But my best time I think was in San Diego and the Civic Center. Right by the railway station there.
What happened there?
Yeah, well, I had a good play there. We had a competition there. We had a competition of three sticker man.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Three sticker a person. And the third stick, he beat the man. And I think that was the best time I had.
But were you afraid of the guy?
I never feared anyone. I never fear no one of the stick. I don't want to know your name, I didn't want to know where you're from, I don't know what to do. When I be there, I say, come to fight young or old. I never had fear of being anyone. Never had fear. I play anybody at any time. For that matter, in Moruga, I play under Bubul. Flambo, you know called Flambo? I play with that. I play with Gas Flam. All these things I play under. I like it so much that I never fear no one, you know?
Does the drum playing have anything to do with you?
Yes, a lot.
Yeah.
Not with me alone. Yeah. Any stick player, whether you are old stick player, whether you are long stick player, or whether you like stick fight, once you hear that drum cutting after the cutter, he is the man that calls you and says, that man has got
the drum. So the man who cutting the drum,
the messenger.
If he can play good, you play better stick fight?
Better stick fight. Because long time, when we had two drums long time, I pull on a cutter, and when we go to catch bird, that day me left the bush.
I come.
When I hear man cut the drum, I gone.
Yeah,
I gone, I can't. It's that time I gone. I don't call it.
Yeah.
Alright. I never had no love for carnival, but I'm stick.
Stick fighting. You leave everything else.
Leave everything
else. Stay by the stick.
And last time there was a couple of years ago, I don't remember. I stand up and I got for my job in Magdalena. Magdalena Junction, not Magdalena, not Magdalena. And the happy days there when we are left there and approach with Pam's Club.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we did that Pam's Club 2 o'clock in the morning. We had a nice trip, took about 15 players, and along with followers, there are a lot of dogs. There are a lot of followers about. There are 60, 70 followers. They bought stick men had about 15. 15 as a crew. 15 group girls.
crowd that turned up for this stick fighting competition surprised even the organizers. This goes to show that the Kalinda may be dying in other parts of the country, but certainly not in Mayaro.
So,
yes.
You see the last one behind here?
Yes.
My uncle took me and bring me home here.
Yeah.
And put me on like that.
Alright.
You understand?
That way? Okay.
I last take so. Mm-hmm. There I became the greatest breaker. Like if I play in here, I will come here and break.
Okay.
Instead of breaking here to get last one behind, okay. Get last one back.
But go back so again, let me
so
see
I
where
you come here.
Yes. Yeah. What about your rib, that side?
Well, if I'm here, if I'm here, my performance, I will break here.
All
right. If I'm here, I'll break here.
All right. Okay.
You understand?
Oh, so
I would break here.
All right.
That is bad.
Yes.
To break here,
yeah.
He could hit you in the mouth.
He could hit you where?
In your head, yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay.
No, like killer whale. Hit a man and stick so there, the man breaks, he takes him in the mouth.
Uh-uh.
That is a nuts man.
Yeah.
But if you do me that, yeah. I will break so.
All right.
They stick out to me by stick there.
Yeah.
You understand?
I understand what I'm doing.
That depends on here and yeah. Thin so.
Thin so, right.
With that stick so that way gliding, uh-huh. So you can run on your stick.
All right, and get your hand.
Get your hand.
Yeah.
But if you break like that, you break like that,
yeah.
Break like that.
You get away.
You break like that. Mm-hmm. You get away.
Oh, I see. Okay.
But you don't stand up just so and break like that.
You
have to come here.
Okay.
You put the stick close out. Uh-huh. You understand?
Yeah.
But the guys and then you really stop and do that.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna push your hand here, uh-huh. Lash on the hand.
Uh-huh.
If I break a stick, run on your finger.
Okay.
But if you break a stick like that,
yeah.
I give you a stick for your face,
uh-huh.
I will break here, you can drop here.
Yeah,
I will break that way.
Uh-huh.
So I have half and half uh-huh. to my body, to your stick.
Yeah, right.
You understand this way?
So that's the way you do?
That's the way I did.
Okay.
And that's the way that people really love this Ninja Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
This one is the clearest breaker I ever see.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I break, I show you where I break from.
You're right.
You understand?
Yeah.
I show you the art,
mm-hmm.
the skill,
And everything,
and you must have this side to do that.
To do that.
Yeah.
And what about the reflexes?
Well, this is what?
Mm.
If you don't have that,
mm.
you better don't play no stick.
You better go out
still. You better stay away.
Yeah.
You must have this side and reflexes.
Yeah.
You must have that. But sometimes a man show you a stick here,
mm.
and you break and hit it. You have to come back here.
Yeah.
Then you have to come here. But if you break, so you left that all that open to hit across,
yeah.
hit so.
Right.
The man just have a stick, bang,
mm.
bang.
Mm.
If you're here, my dad was sick and it breaks, so you run on the stick.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're bound to break here, come back on the break here.
Yeah.
But you must be moving this
yeah.
foot. Or moving.
Moving so
foot.
Somewhere, yeah.
You can't be standing up just to put your stick here.
You'll get your ribs broken or something.
Something like that.
Yeah.
But I used to play like this. I used to be like this. Mm-hmm. So if I come here.
Yes. Yes.
If I hear and hit me, I come here.
Yes, yes.
So I send you there.
Okay.
And if I want to hit you to send you so,
mm-hmm.
I could break here and send you so and hit you here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how I used to play.
Mm.
But most of I go stand up and take a lash.
Mm.
Most of I go stand up and take a lash to the head.
Yeah.
Take a lash by the mouth here. I put a stick here.
You never do that?
Here. No, I done it once when I had a young fellow and my uncle showed me. Okay, yeah.
You do all that.
You just defend yourself.
Yeah. So your uncle was a great stick player?
Yeah, they was good.
All right.
They was good.
I'm not
stick, quick.
Yeah, quick.
You could cut it, you could cut a pretty big so.
Yeah.
And bring it down to the side.
Quick is the only thing for
yeah,
stick.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mm.
Quick. When you cut it, you can bring it down to the side.
Mm-hmm.
They bring anaerobic, anaerobic, sometimes they ban it, they say not good or anything like that.
Yeah.
But this, the real master.
That's it, that is stick.
This is my link on everything.
Uh-oh.
Samba, samba, pretty woman. Oh, Lord, oh. Look, the length of the pole is in the power gravel.
That was my road match.
So, the stick must have a certain length?
No, well, according to your length.
Right,
yeah,
to
you, to you, to you.
Now, to the man.
Like real composition, like what they had there.
Mm.
You don't get a man coming and play his stick or anybody's stick.
Yeah.
The committee must have two sticks to give you.
Oh, they have the
you
stick.
You have to go by that rule.
Oh, they have the stick.
Because sometimes you come and take that weapon. Uh-huh. If a man break here, stick on the lap and get him over here, you know?
Yeah.
So you have your own thing and you know that you don't have your thing. You have your
man. Now, I want to ask you this question. Now, I know as a young man growing up, I used to hear about mounted stick.
Yes, it has.
Now, yeah, if they have mounted stick, and perhaps in your days, perhaps you have met some of that. How you survive that mountain stick? Yes. Mountain stick, because I hear it's not human.
The fellow that I used to play with, that was my riding partner.
All right.
We went to the Coastrace Junction.
All right.
And he break a stick from a man.
Yeah.
It's cut half and half.
Yeah.
And a bee just fly with the stick on going.
You what?
A bee.
Uh-oh.
And when he put it attack the man, he pelted away the stick. But the next half, he threw it away.
Well, tell him where your grandmother
is. I remember Fred Daniel went to
San Diego.
Give him a chance.
I remember Fred Daniel, San Diego, and he break a stick at a man.
Yeah.
And he feel like he hold hair, like he going crazy.
He break a stick?
Yeah, he break the stick, you know.
Uh-huh.
And like he was going crazy.
Okay.
Stick for days.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And I can also remember myself in Rockaro.
Uh-huh.
A Carnival Monday.
Right.
On the San Diego Road.
Mm.
By Anand Ramshop there.
Mm.
That's on the right hand side of the right beach. And they go like you're going to.
I was there.
Mm.
When I reach, I don't have to make a friend of Jay. I just hold a stick and say, well, stick for anybody.
Right.
And I was like this, but there was a gentleman who I overheard telling people, the man reached hand me the stick.
Mm-hmm.
So when
the man
I
reached hand me the stick.
Hand me the stick. He was behind my back.
Yeah.
He was wearing a white shirt. Mm. With a black hat and a black pants and a black shoe. So as I hold my stick like that and I dance in here, I feel my hair raised. So I look around so.
Uh-huh.
It look around so like I see 3%.
Uh-huh.
So I come back and I start to dance here.
Uh-huh.
As I do so, I see 2.
Uh-huh.
I see one more get fed up.
Uh-huh.
So when I dance here and I see 1, I turn back so.
Uh-huh.
And I beat the stick like that and I say, well, that man hit me and stick here.
Uh-huh.
When I pull up and I break the stick, everybody tell me, don't play again. Stop playing. My father, he loved to see me tell me don't play.
Uh-uh. He saw something.
And about 2 years after, there was a bar right there.
Right.
I was working in the government.
Uh-huh.
So when I came home, I was around 11.
Uh-huh.
The train mother told me, a gentleman in a white mask that I rescued over a child came and asked for you. They said, he'll be back. I said, all right. So I changed my clothes and things. I came up, be back, and I sit down. I go back inside. I left. I go to the bar before that. A man left a nip of whiskey and I say he'll be back. You know? Oi, so. By the inside, they called me and said, the man come. He asked me, could you remember me?
Uh-huh.
I said, no.
Uh-huh.
He said, look at me good.
Uh-huh.
I said, I can't face you at all.
Uh-huh.
He said, you're wrong, a guy. I said, neither. He said, let me tell you something. If you remember the day, the Carnival Monday at the Bishop. But then you tell me that.
Your memory came back.
I say, yeah. Mm-hmm. I say, you the guy that hit me the stick and offered me a drink of whiskey finish.
Mm-hmm.
He said, let me tell you something. He said, the man with the button Talparo. He said, I'm going to send me for you.
Okay.
But he was stronger than me.
You were stronger than him?
Yeah. He said, from that day to now, look, the stick in the car trunk here, show it to me.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I've never played again.
Okay.
And he showed me the stick.
Never play again?
Never play again. That I was the oldest man playing his life. Because my stick was done, man. Yeah. But when I done that break, I come back and I break this down. If I had to break so, all gone.
Okay.
I break so. So I time up, you stick there.
Yes.
Feel like splinters bound my face then.
Okay.
And I break it.
So what in that stick? That stick had all extra power in it then?
Extra power.
Okay.
That it may be in part of the body, just make it a cripple, man.
Yes.
But I tell you personally, I just play strict, natural.
Yeah, but you didn't used to protect yourself.
Natural.
You never protect yourself.
Never.
Having something to protect yourself.
If I go in the plastic, I go tell the man up there, I am leaving, I want to come back.
Okay.
But they're going to put nazis on my skin.
Yeah.
Oh, because if I be talking here,
yeah,
in those days, stick the same day. So as we talk here, we say, like, we're going to stand down, I hear a drum beat, I say, drop me.
Yeah.
When I drop the stick, I don't know you. I only ball cock to fight young old, I play.
Right.
And we leave on there, we go to the I say, drop me here too. Once I hear a drum, I gone.
Yeah.
So I to play. But the other fellow guys are going to the cemetery and take out stick, rub this, when they smell them stink and all kind of
so,
cacaja, red lavender, quicksilver, peace leaf on the hand, and thing on the kerchief and all kind of thing.
So you feel that the good old man up there protected that day?
All
from,
the time.
From
that was my leader, playing stick.
Right.
Because if I lie down sleep and you call me, I don't have time to get nothing.
Yeah.
I just jump in the car and go.
And just go.
And because I remember I sitting down here on Sunday and three cars, four cars pull up here. Bidding for me.
But you think this mounted stick used to help people?
Yeah.
But it wasn't fair though.
No, that is what I tell you. In competition.
Neither.
Oh, I see.
Because it could cause these things. Because a stick like this, you will test it. You see, they're bending. So you play with that. But then do a stick so you see like an arrow so.
Yeah.
Man hits you, bam, that'll go right away down cut
you. Oh, I see.
You break here, you'll lap in the back and hit you.
All right.
Yes, sir. You know what I mean? After me, I have to break and put you inside.
Yes.
Because you hit your back in your back.
Yes.
But stick me since it's a hard stick.
All right.
So it was dangerous with a warp stick.
Oh, it was a mounted stick.
It was also dangerous with a mounted stick.
Yeah.
Because sometimes somebody send you to spoil me.
Mm-hmm.
And I go, sometimes I touch your stick with a hand so. And there's something what happened there. Bruises, blood, and steady bleeding. You have professional in this.
Yeah.
That amateur. That who know learning.
Learning. And have and different stages.
And different stages.
Yeah.
But have, like a teacher, like a good teacher. How to break a stick, how to defend yourself, how to hit a stick, and all these things.
But in stick playing, they put out, like in boxing, you have different weight and different class.
Well,
do they ever open, does anybody, young stick fighter, go with a
mature
man as you and things like
up
that?
Up here, you'll find a fellow that can hold a stick after I pull him out.
All right. So you're not good enough, you'll get split.
But with me, nobody can pull me out. Because I never wanted to know who you is.
Uh-huh.
Where's your name?
Uh-huh.
Where you're from? Where's your height? I know I wanted to know that.
Yeah.
Because when I had that club there, I had a girl there.
Yeah.
My son gone hold a stick. His mother pulled him away. I said, we pull him away for?
Uh-huh.
I said, go back inside there. And he go and he play and he come out. I said, I didn't send you. Even though you can't play, don't play. That is it, you understand?
Yes.
I never played a man for my guy yet. Right. And nobody never pulled me out.
Oh, so
people just love to see me go in the ring.
So it's a matter of bravery.
It's a matter of bravery. Right. And you put your mind to it that me afraid in this John, me afraid in Harry, me afraid nobody.
Thank you. want to enjoy it. I love it. But I want to play somebody some wood, you know. I want to play them there some wood.
The fight tonight, it was unfair because what took place there, they didn't make proper decision on the judging. Proper decision on the judging. Yeah, at a certain point, because it have true that a man hit me double stick and they still end up getting points on me there.
Name is what?
Lolly.
Eh?
King Lolly.
King Lolly?
Lolly, yeah.
Why are you
coming on stick over? Why you don't put them on here?
What I want to tell you, Trinidad and Tobago.